Hello everyone, I'm Sushmita Sarkar from RV College of Engineering. I welcome you all in the last lecture, lecture 12 in Power System Analysis 2 course, module 1. So in this particular lecture, we'll be learning about the acceleration factor used in Gauss-Seidel method for load flow analysis. Fine, so what is an acceleration factor and why do we use this? Fine, so the convergence can be accelerated by using this particular factor, which we denote it as alpha. Then this is used to update the calculated value of voltage corresponding to the kth iteration. For whichever iteration you are doing it, in that particular voltage value will be for that particular bus will be updated immediately by using this acceleration factor. And how do we do that? Let us look at the formula. So this formula says it is Vp accelerated. Basically, you're accelerating this voltage at bus P for kth iteration. So we write it as Vp of k accelerated is equal to Vp k minus 1, which is your previous iteration value, plus alpha Vp of k minus Vp of k minus 1. So if you have to understand in an practical system, so how do I write it? As for an example, let us write an accelerating bus 3 voltage at fourth iteration. So how do you write it as? So basically you're accelerating the voltage at bus 3 for the fourth iteration. So V3 of 4 acceleration will equal to the previous iteration value of this bus. So previous iteration value will be V3 of 3 plus alpha V3 of 4, that is your present iteration, minus the difference between the last two iterations multiplied by alpha plus the previous iteration value will accelerate the voltage faster, which will help you to reach the convergence also in less time. Fine. So what is the value of this alpha? Now the question comes, what is this alpha? What value we should take it this alpha value as? So this alpha value will be usually taken as 1.4 and 1.6. And how do we know that? This value is basically found by trial and error method. So we usually considered alpha as 1.4 or 1.6. If alpha is not suitably chosen, then instead of converging, the system may diverge. Okay. So please be very careful when you choose the value of alpha. So let us understand the concept of this acceleration factor with the help of one problem. How do we do it? So let us take a problem. The load flow data for a sample power system is shown below. Determine the bus voltage after first iteration using Gauss-Seidel method. Okay, so here we are going to, let us do this problem by taking alpha value as, we'll be considering the alpha value as 1.4. Let us consider for this particular problem, we'll do this problem by taking alpha value as 1.4. Fine, so here is your line data given. And here is your bus data given. So line data will help you to draw the network as well as to form the Y bus. And bus data will help you to know the type of buses we have in the system. Fine, so the first bus data is clearly written. The type is very much mentioned, slack bus. Second bus is a PV bus where you have the value of V, UOP, the magnitude of V as well as the Q limits. So here I have taken this particular problem to make you understand that though it is a PV bus, but this particular bus 2 has the generation as well as the load. Okay, so very careful when you write the P2 and Q2 for this particular bus. That means whenever you write, calculate the bus voltage at this particular bus. Fine, so remember at this particular bus is where I have the generator. That means you are injecting the power at this particular bus as well as you're drawing the power from the same bus. Fine. And one more thing to be noted down in this particular problem is the values of generator and load is not given in per unit, but the voltage is given in per unit, whereas generator and load values are given as megawatts and MVAR. So what is the first thing we do it? Okay, so we take it as a per unit. We convert into a per unit value. So how do we do that? So to do that, if it is not mentioned, then you please assume your base value as the highest among these value, or you can also consider it as 100. So you can either take it as 100 MVA base, or you can give the highest among this, whichever is given as 60. So for this particular problem, I have taken as a 60 as the base value. Fine. So before converting this, let us see what is the network and how does the YBUS looks for this. Fine. So the YBUS is formed like this. Please remember, don't forget to convert the impedances into the series admittances, and then only you form the YBUS. Fine. So this YBUS basically says about, I have a bus. Okay. So I have a connection like this from the bus. Fine. So this is bus number one. This is bus number two. Fine. Or I'll go for this bus number two. I will erase and write bus number two separately because I need to show that bus number one is a slack bus. So and this I will take it as a bus number two, and this I will take it as a bus number three. Fine. So okay, this is bus number three. So I'll take a different color to make you understand. Bus one is a slack bus, so definitely you have a generator. So the direction of the arrow will be over here. So you have a generator at this bus because it's slack bus. Now bus number two, you have a generator as well as a load. So your generator will come over here and load will go out. So this is basically you have generator over here and load over here. Bus number three is a PQ bus, so completely you have a load. So this is how your system looks. Fine, this is how the network looks for the given data. So from this, we form the YBUS by converting the respective line impedances into an admittances. Fine, so what is the next? We have considered a 60 MVA as a base. So when I take the 60 MVA base, my respective values are converted in per unit, and I have written in the boxes so you can check it out. Fine, so next, since you have taken 60, so this becomes one, fine. So let PQ buses, we usually take it as a flat voltage profile. So here is the third bus is a PQ bus, fine. So V3 of zero will be 1+J0. Now, what is that? First bus is slack bus, so as per your algorithm, so you go for the next bus, you increase your bus count. So second bus is your PV bus. So what is the first step in PV bus? Check the Q limits by using the formula. So when we check the Q limits by using this formula, I get an answer of 0.07725 per unit. So 0.07725 per unit is within the limit because your limit says 0 less than equal to Q2 less than equal to 0.588 per unit. This is the limit given in the problem. Okay, after converting into a per unit. So my answer of Q2 cal is very much within the limit. Hence, this bus is going to be treated as PV bus. So if it is treated as a PV bus, which means you need to calculate delta temporary. Fine, so your VP magnitude, the magnitude of this particular bus is going to be specified value. And in the question, the specified value is given as 1.03 per unit. Fine. So next, so I calculate V2 of one temporary. So because I required from this only delta value, so please substitute the values over here from the respective. So here very much careful, you have to be P2 and Q2. So what will be your P2, guys? P2 is going to be what? P2G. Okay. P2G. Minus of P2L. Okay, P2G minus of P2L. So what is P2G given as? Okay, so if you want to cross check, let us go back and check what is the P2G value is given as. P2 generation is 0.33. P2L is 0.833. Okay, so you have 0.33 minus 0.833 will give you the answer of P2. Similarly, Q2 value will be Q2G. What is your Q2G over there? Is your Q2 calculated, whichever you have done it, minus your Q2L. This is your Q2L. So Q2G will be your Q2 calculated. Whatever we have calculated, that value minus 0.416 will give you the value of Q2. Fine. So hope I'm clear with this. Fine. So basically I have putting over here P2G is equal to P2L. Similarly, Q2 also will be equal to Q2G minus Q2L. Okay. This Q2G is nothing but Q2 calculated. This Q2G is nothing but Q2 calculated, which we have just now, that is 0.077. Okay, so that value you have to substitute over here minus the load reactive power, you have to do it, and then you substitute in this equation of V2 of 1 temporary, solve this and get the answer. So we get, after solving, we get this answer. So in this, what happens? I don't require the magnitude. I required only the angle. Okay, because it is a PV bus. The limits are where the Q2 calculated is very much within the limits. And hence, the V magnitude of this particular bus will be is equal to V2 specified, which is 1.03. So look at, see, I have written over here. Fine, V21 specified is equal to delta21 temporary. So this is your specified value 1.03, and this value will be as it is minus 2.294. So this is, I got all around the value of V2 of 1 after first iteration. Fine, now I have to apply the value of accelerated, V2 accelerated value. You have to, with the help of acceleration factor, you need to accelerate this value. So what is the formula of acceleration? Vp of acceleration of k is equal to Vp of k minus 1 plus alpha Vp of k minus Vp k minus 1. Fine, so substitute over there. So basically I'm calculating V2 of 1 accelerated is equal to V2 of 0, k minus 1 is your, this is your k, so minus 1 will give you 0, plus 1.4. We have taken, we have considered the value of alpha as 1.4 for this particular problem, and V2 of 1 minus V2 of 0. When you substitute these values, you can see the V2 of 1 accelerated, you get it as 1.03 at an angle of minus 3.21 degrees. So basically you can see the drastic difference in your, the difference mainly in your angle, not in the magnitude. So fine, so this is your V2 accelerated 1 value. So after this, what do we do, guys? We check the delta of V2 of 1. You check the change in your last two iteration value. So delta of V2 of 1 will be V2 of 1. This V2 of 1, guys, should be use your accelerated value. Fine. So I'll write over here so that you should not get confused. This is your accelerated value. Okay. So this is V2 of 1 accelerated value minus V2 of 0 will give you the delta V2 of 1. Fine. Next. We'll be calculating a bus 3. Bus 3 is your PQ bus. So simply using the Gauss-Seidel equation, get the value of V3 of 1. We got this. Now after you get the value of V3 1, find out V3 of 1 accelerated. So V3 of accelerated, your answer comes to 1.01 at an angle. So you can see there is a change. Okay. So there is a change in the value V3 of 1 of accelerated. Then you find delta of V3 of 1, which is the difference between of V3 of 1 accelerated. So here also it has to be your accelerated value. V3 of 1 accelerated minus V3 of 0 will give you 0.076. Okay. So I hope it's clear. So this delta V max, auntie, unless it is not, whichever is the greater value in all the deltas for a particular iteration, is not less than or equal to tolerance value, you need to go for the next iteration. So that is what we say, the convergence is not yet reached, and hence we need to go for next iteration. And if it comes equal to or less than tolerance value, then we say system is converged. So that is what we are trying to say. If this particular value of alpha is not chosen correctly, then instead of convergence, your system will completely diverge. That means you will have absolutely no solution for that particular system. Okay, so I hope it is clear. Let us know what are the advantages of GS method. Fine, so we have from last so many lectures, we have learned about GS technique. So what are the advantages, what you have understood so far? The very first thing is, it's a very simple technique. Basically, you are applying a GS method in a static load flow equation, and it is just to find out the voltages at every buses. Once you come to know about the voltages, you can easily calculate slack bus power, line flows, and line losses. Okay, so it's basically a simple technique. It requires a less memory, fine, so which we have seen, and the less computational time per iteration. Every iteration will take really less time to do it. Fine, these are the major three advantages which we see in GS method. Let us see what are the drawbacks or the disadvantages in GS method. The very first thing is a slow rate of convergence resulting in large number of iterations. So students, in the next module, you also will be learning about other two techniques for load flow analysis, which we call it as Newton-Raphson and fast decoupled load flow method. So when we look into those two methods, we find the GS method takes longer time for the convergence, to reach to a convergence. It takes more number of iterations to converge. So you people can literally see the difference between the three methods when you use a software package for a single network, simple network you solve in that, and just compare all the three results in whether you are using a MyPower software package or you are using an ETAP, and do it and definitely check, apply all the three methods for a same network and see that which method takes less number of iterations to reach convergence. Fine, so basically you will definitely find that the Gauss-Seidel takes more number of iterations to reach to convergence. Then increase the number of iterations directly with the increased number of buses. As your system goes larger and larger, it will take more time, it will take more number of iterations. Okay, and one more very important thing is the effect of convergence. The convergence criteria will get affected by the choice of your slack bus. Okay, it depends which bus you have considered as slack bus. Based on that, it affects also the convergence. Fine, so based on all these three above drawbacks, this GS method we usually apply only for a very small systems. Okay, so after knowing the advantages and disadvantages, let us go through a short features I have made it. Just let us go by parameter wise parameter and how does the GS works on these parameter. Fine, so we'll say the features of GS method. The very first, we talk about the coordinates. So work well with rectangular coordinates. So when you take the rectangular coordinates means nothing but rectangular form. So basically we are talking about the real and imaginary part. So whether your Y bus or your power or your voltages, when you go for a rectangular coordinate form, it gives you much faster results. Arithmetic operations, you know, it will take least in number to complete one iteration. We are not talking about the entire iteration time. We are telling about per iteration, it takes less time compared to other two methods. Fine. So it requires less time per iteration, but increases with the number of buses. So as your number of buses increases, because please recall your Gauss-Seidel equation. So Vp of k, when you write, as the number of buses will increase, the equation also will increase. The number of voltages YQP, YPQ and VQ will also keep increasing. And if that increase, definitely per iteration, time also will increase. So convergence is linear, which we have noticed. Number of iterations are larger in number, increases with increase in buses. We also talk about that. As your number of iterations will increase, definitely time will also increase. And we have also discussed the choice of slack bus is very important in case of GS method, because it affects your convergence timing. Fine. And accuracy, when we talk about it comparative to the other two methods which you guys are going to study, it is less accurate. Okay, so these are the few parameters, keep it in mind. And the very important questions we keep asking, the comparison between all the three methods. So keep these points in mind and write the comparison of other two methods also. Fine, so with this, let me see what is next. Okay, so we have a quiz. Fine, I know all of you are quite interested, and definitely you know the answers of all my quizzes. Fine, if you are listening to my lectures carefully. So let us see the first question. In Gauss-Seidel method of power flow problem, the number of iterations may be reduced if the correction in voltage at each bus is multiplied by. Yes, what is the answer? Answer is acceleration factor alpha. So if you accelerate your voltages at every buses in each iteration, definitely you will reach to the convergence faster. Fine. So let us see what is the question number two. In Gauss-Seidel method of power flow problem, the nature of convergence is? It is linear. So as you increase the number of buses, it is also going to take the, it's proportional to your time and other things also, fine? So it's a linear. Question number three, why Gauss-Seidel method is limited only to smaller systems, okay? Just now we have discussed, guys, why it is applicable only for smaller systems, because we know if the system increases or the number of buses increases, the computational time per iteration will also increase, which also reduce the rate of the convergence will also reduce, and the effect of the choice of slack bus will, or for a huge system also will get affected if your slack bus is not chosen properly. So these are all the reasons of using or applying a GS method for a smaller system. Okay, so I hope all of you have enjoyed module one. Okay, and I'm able to explain you all the concepts of Y bus, via inspection or singular transformation method, the network modeling, the load flow concepts, the basic concepts, and the techniques, which we call it as a GS method. That is what you had in your module one. So with this, I wind up my module one lectures, and thank you for listening all my lectures. Have a nice day. Thank you once again. All the best for your future endeavors.